My dear brothers and sisters, I welcome you today for the Amrutavani TV program. I am glad to meet you once again in this program. Few years back, I said some messages about C, that is starting from the letter C, that is Church, Christ, Christianity, etc. And I am privileged to share once again few messages which are there in my heart with you, and I am thankful to all of you for watching these programs. Especially I thank our dear brother God servant Walter Maben for giving me this opportunity, and also the coordinators of KMN network for giving me this opportunity. Today especially I wanted to start this series of messages starting with the number 3, different subjects involving the number 3. Today I am going to share with you on 3 crosses of Calvary. Many people know about cross. Whenever we think about cross, we think about the Lord Jesus Christ. Crucifixion was a very harsh punishment and sentence 2000 years back during the Roman rule. Very dangerous criminals, robbers, anti-nationals, thieves, anti-social elements were hanged on the cross so that other people may take warning and they keep away from such activities. A person who is very dangerous to the society, he is hanged on the cross. Crucifixion was a capital punishment like what we have today, hanging. So when we think about cross, usually we think about the cross of the Lord Jesus Christ. But the cross of the Lord Jesus Christ was not the only cross on the mountain of Calvary 2000 years back. When Jesus died, there were 3 crosses. You can imagine, think in your mind about 3 crosses in front of you. One cross was left side, another cross was right side, and the cross of Christ was in between. 2 thieves were hanging either side of the Lord Jesus Christ, one on the left side, one on the right side, and Jesus Christ was on the central cross. Now we will see the significance, importance of these three crosses on the Calvary. The first cross, the left side cross, was belonging to a thief. Even the last cross, the right side cross, was also belonging to a thief. This first cross signifies cross of rebellion. It was not a simple cross. It was a cross of rebellion. Why? The thief was on that cross. Although he was hanging on the cross, he didn't realize his sinfulness. What all he did in his life, the crimes he has committed, the murders he has committed, the way he looted people. He never realized that he was a sinner. He was just thinking about himself. He was so selfish that he wanted to escape from that punishment of the cross. While hanging on the cross also, he looked at Jesus Christ, who was on the central cross, and said like this, which is recorded in the book of Bible, Luke's Gospel, chapter 23, verse 39. Then one of the criminals who were hanged blasphemed him, saying, "If you are the Christ, save yourself and us." Although he was hanging on the cross, he was near to death at any time, yet he was rebelling against God. He was rebelling against society. He was rebelling against his own family. He was rebelling against his own parents. He was rebelling against authorities. He didn't realize that I am a sinner. That's why I am hanging on the cross. This punishment is just for me. This punishment is right for me. He didn't repent even at the point of death. He was just rebelling against God, against everybody. He was so self-centered. He was so selfish. That's why I gave the title to that cross. It was a cross of rebellion. Even today, my dear brothers and sisters, there are so many people who are committing so many sins, who are doing so many evil deeds, who are going in wicked ways, looting people, doing injustice to people. They are so self-centered. They want to grab everything for them. But when they are caught, they don't have the remorse. They don't repent for what they have done. They are rebelling against God. They are rebelling against society. They are rebelling against everybody. That is what the cross of rebellion signifies. Now we'll shift our focus to the next cross, which is on the right side of the Lord Jesus Christ. It also belonged to a thief. He was also a fellow companion of this robber. They both looted, they both robbed people, they both did all sinful things. That's why he was also hanging on another cross. But something happened to him. Both of them, they were making fun of Jesus Christ. Even this thief who was on the second cross was also mocking God, was also reviling the Lord Jesus Christ. He also said, "If you are Son of God, save yourself and save us also." They joined with the crowd below who were staring and making fun of the Lord Jesus Christ. And he also made fun of him. But one thing happened on the central cross. There the Lord Jesus Christ prayed for these people, saying, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they do." In Luke's Gospel, chapter 23, verse 34, says like this, "My dear brothers and sisters, the Lord Jesus Christ paid for the forgiveness of these two thieves and other people who are crucifying him. This prayer of forgiveness, this greatest prayer which the Lord Jesus Christ did on the cross of Calvary, touched the second thief's heart. The Holy Spirit convicted him, convinced him, and made him to realize his sinfulness. Then the second thief looked at the other thief who was hanging on the left cross and said like this, 'Do you not even fear God, seeing you are under the same condemnation? And we indeed justly, for we receive the due reward of our deeds. But this man has done nothing wrong.'" Luke's Gospel, chapter 23, verses 40 and 41. My dear brothers and sisters, the second thief, although he was also a wicked person, robber, sinner, did all evil things throughout his life. Something happened in his heart. Something happened in his life at that moment when the Lord Jesus Christ prayed. The Holy Spirit pierced his heart and he was convicted. He realized his sinfulness and looked at the other thief, said, "What you are doing is wrong. We have received the penalty of our wicked deeds. But this man has not done anything wrong." And he looked at the Lord Jesus Christ and prayed like this in verse 42. "Lord, remember me when you come into your kingdom." My dear brothers and sisters, I call this cross of the second thief the cross of repentance. He was also a thief. He was also a robber. He was also a wicked man. But he repented for what he has done. He repented for his sinful condition. That's why we read in Proverbs chapter 28 verse 13 records like this. If someone hides their sins, they will not receive forgiveness. If they confess their sins and forsake their sins, they will receive the mercy and grace of God. My dear brothers and sisters, this thief receives God's pardon. That's why you could hear the greatest ever statement ever a man could hear from God. The Lord Jesus Christ told him in verse 43, "Assuredly I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise." What a joy, what a wonderful privilege for a thief, for a sinner going to heaven. He never did any good thing in his whole life. His whole life was a wicked life. His whole life was a trouble for other people. He never did any good deeds. He never went for any pilgrimage. He never helped people. What all he has done was looting, killing, robbing, raping, all the wicked things. But the great thing this thief did was, he realized his sinfulness, looked at the Lord Jesus Christ, believed on him that he is the savior of the mankind. And he also believed Jesus Christ died for his sins, paid the penalty of his sins, and he is the savior. And looked at the Lord Jesus Christ and asked him to forgive him and to take him into his kingdom. He must have thought, after my death, in the resurrection, the Lord will forgive him, take him to heaven. But the Lord Jesus Christ assured him, "Verily, I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise." Oh, what a wonderful privilege for that thief. The 12 disciples of the Lord Jesus Christ didn't get this privilege. Jesus had 70 disciples. He had 120 disciples. He had thousands of followers behind him. Of course, all of them forsake him when he was hanging on the cross. But nobody had the privilege to go to heaven along with the Lord Jesus Christ. Only the second thief who was hanging on the right side cross had that privilege. That's why I call that cross, cross of repentance. Now we will come to the center cross, where the Lord Jesus Christ was hanging. This cross signifies the cross of redemption. It was also belonging to a robber. In fact, he was the leader of the robbers, Barabbas. These three crosses were meant for three robbers. And the central cross was for Barabbas, who was the hardest criminal among them. But the Lord Jesus Christ took the place of the leader of these robbers, Barabbas. He set him free. He took his cross on his shoulders and he paid the penalty of the sins of the whole mankind. Not only Barabbas, whole mankind, from Adam to the last man ever born. My dear brothers and sisters, this is the cross of redemption. This is the cross which divided heaven and hell. This is the cross which divided the time. This is the cross which gave you and me new life, new hope, eternal life. And this cross was meant only for the Lord Jesus Christ, who was the sinless Son of God. Although he was Son of God, he became Lamb of God on the cross of Calvary, on the middle cross, on the central cross. My dear brothers and sisters, now we saw in short the significance of these three crosses. There were three crosses on that particular day on Mount Calvary. And one cross was the cross of rebellion. Another cross was the cross of repentance. But the central cross was the cross of redemption. In Luke's Gospel, chapter 9, verse 23, the Lord Jesus Christ says like this, "If anyone wants to follow me, let him deny himself, take up his cross daily and follow me." What does that mean? It means, if you want to follow the Lord Jesus Christ, you have to bear a cross. It is not wearing a symbolic cross on your neck, on your body. You have to bear a cross in your life, day-to-day life. What does a cross signify? As I told you in the beginning of this message, cross signifies death, shame, punishment, reproach. When somebody was carrying that cross, the whole society looked at him and said, "No, it should not happen to anybody. Such a cruel punishment." So cross signifies that person who is carrying that cross is useless for the society. There is no good. It is simple to carry the cross. But the Lord Jesus Christ said, if anyone wants to follow me, let him deny himself, take up his cross daily and follow me. We have to carry a cross in our life. All mankind is meant to carry a cross in their life. There is no other way. God has tailor-made a cross for you. But the question is, which cross are you carrying? Is it the cross of rebellion, like the first thief, who was reviling, making fun of God even at the point of death, joking, didn't take God seriously, didn't take sin seriously, he was playing with sin, he was carrying the cross of rebellion, and the other cross of repentance. That thief who was also a criminal, repented of his wicked deeds, asked for the forgiveness of his sins from the Savior, and he got the privilege to go to heaven along with the Lord Jesus Christ. Now there are only two crosses for us. We have to carry either the cross of rebellion or the cross of repentance. We cannot carry the central cross of redemption. It belongs to the Lord Jesus Christ. Nobody ever could take his place. It was meant for the Lord Jesus Christ. We cannot carry that cross which took the sins of the whole mankind on its place. Jesus Christ died for your sins and my sins. Because our hands have committed so many sins from our childhood, even till today, knowingly, unknowingly, the holy hands of the Lord Jesus Christ were pierced with the cruel nails. Because our feet went to all wicked places, we rebelled against God, we rebelled against parents, we rebelled against our spouses, we rebelled against the society. We did so many things going to all bad places. The holy feet of the Lord Jesus Christ were nailed. Because of what we thought, all the wicked thoughts in our mind, the head of the Lord Jesus Christ was pierced with the crown of thorns. Because of our wrong talks, we hurt people, we told lies, and we had bad looks. His face was bitten. Because of the evil desires we had, his heart was pierced with a spear. He took all our iniquities and sins on the cruel cross of Calvary, the central cross. My dear brothers and sisters, we cannot take that cross, but we can trust on that cross for our redemption. Now, you have to decide which cross you have to carry. If you carry the cross of rebellion, you have no other way except to go to hell. Hell is nothing but eternal punishment. You will suffer forever and ever, but heaven is eternal blessing. You will rejoice forever and ever. If you trust in the Lord Jesus Christ, you will go to heaven. For that you need to carry the cross of repentance. Today is the right day. Today is the day of salvation. My dear brothers and sisters, make a decision to trust on the central cross of redemption, on the Lord Jesus Christ. He loves you. He gave his life for you. He died. He was buried and he rose again on the third day according to scriptures. Still, he has his hands open towards you. He is calling you to come near to him. He wants to embrace you. He wants to love you. He wants to change you. He wants to make you a new person. I am going to pray a simple prayer for you. Please close your eyes wherever you are. Look at the central cross in your heart, invite the Lord Jesus Christ into your life. He is willing to come. Our ever-loving and living God, unchanging God, the Father of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we thank you and praise you, Lord, for this wonderful time you have given to us in the Amritavani TV program to think about the three crosses on the Mount Calvary 2000 years back, the cross of rebellion, the cross of repentance, and the cross of redemption. Lord, till now, knowingly, unknowingly, like the first thief, we have carried the cross of rebellion. We have hurt you. We have rebelled against you. Lord, we have forsaken you. But now we want to carry the cross of repentance. Follow you. Like the second thief, who repented for his evil deeds, turned to the Lord Jesus Christ, and he had that wonderful privilege to go to heaven. Lord, I also pray for our dear brothers and sisters who are all watching this program. Yeah, they are making this prayer, their prayer. Lord, grant them the privilege of eternal life. Bless them. Use them for their glory and kingdom. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.